sectors.
Can you give me the names? Very good. Okay. Secondary sector. So these are the three sectors or three classifications of sectors. These are the three sectors of economy or three classifications of sectors. Three sectors of economy. But my question is how many classifications of sectors we discussed? That is the question. It means you are just given as a one. One classification of sectors based on a production, the nature, type of a products. What about the others? How many are there? Mehul ready to answer. Amritpal also. Yes, Amritpal.
On the basis of production or on the basis of working conditions or ownership.
So three classifications are there. Three classifications of sectors we discuss in this chapter. Sectors of Indian economy as first, on the basis of nature, production or a type of goods, primary, secondary, tertiary. On the basis of employment conditions or working conditions, organized, unorganized. On the basis of ownership, public sector, private sector, joint sector. Three classifications. Anybody else, any other question related with this chapter, sectors of national economy? If you are having any of our queries, you can ask. If anybody having any queries, 10C, online, offline students, they can ask any of our queries related with the sectors of national economy. If you are not having the queries, then we will proceed towards agriculture, geography, agriculture. Agriculture. Dipanch, agriculture is a secondary sector activity. Am I correct? Dipanch. No, maine woh nahi pucha. Just look towards me. Dipanch. Agriculture is the secondary sector activity. Am I correct? Yes or no? Say yes or no. Say yes or no. Bache, we discussed this thing in a previous chapter, sectors of national economy. Yes? Yes, okay. Aapne class pichle do hafton se nahi lagayi. Yes. Agriculture is a primary sector activity. Why? Because it produces raw materials which can't use directly to consume by the consumers. Theek hai? Such type of a goods which can't be used by the consumers for their consumption, they are known as a dash goods. Jaya, Dhingra. What we call to them, the such categories of the goods which can't be used as directly consumption. Intermediate goods, which needs as a further processing. So agriculture produces are the intermediate goods. Clear? Dipanch, clear? The agriculture production has varied from one state towards other. Most of the agriculture production occur in a Punjab, Haryana, as compared to the parts of central India and the northeastern states of India. The reason, techniques of farming. The modern techniques of farming practiced in Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh under the Green Revolution, in which HYB seeds, machines, fertilizers, insecticides, assured irrigation facilities, ensure the more production in Punjab, Haryana, comparatively to central India and northeastern states, where the traditional methods of farming practiced by people. Now the question arises, why such regional disparities of agriculture production occur? What are the reasons responsible for regional disparities in agricultural production? Ek area se, ek state se, dusre state mein production mein variations kyun aati hain? What are the reasons responsible for regional disparities in agricultural production? In which first as a physical factors, geographical factors. First are the geographical factors or physical factors. So geographical factor means rainfall, temperature, type of soil. Very good, Dhruv Mehta. Type of soil, geological structures, climatic conditions. All these are collectively responsible for a production of crops. Where the suitable climatic conditions are favorable for production of crops, more production occur. For example, parts of Punjab. So two to the three crops, these are produced by the farmers in a year, in a three agriculture season. Clear? Three of the agriculture season, kharif, rabi, zayd. Farmers produce the three of the crops. Why? Because favorable climatic conditions. Winters favorable for the wheat, summers favorable for the rice, and in between of a winters and a summer, short tenure of a time period for pulses. Dalein usme ugai jati hain. That season is known as a zayd. Clear? As compared to this in the northeastern states, in Assam, Meghalaya, West Bengal, generally as the winters are not prevailed. Throughout the year, summer conditions are prevailed. So such conditions are favorable for production of a rice thrice in a year in Assam. So it's varying from area to area. More production of a rice possible in the northeastern states comparatively to Punjab. Clear? Uske piche reason kya hai? Assured irrigation. Because of a high rainfall occurred in Mausinram, regular supply of water supports the growth of rice. Okay? So first is the geographical factors. Second, technical factors. Means earlier the most number of agriculture practices occurred on the basis of bullocks, animals, plowshare, wooden plowshares. But now with the introduction of machines, mechanization of agriculture, raised agriculture production. Use of combines, threshers, harvesters, it reduces as the wastage and obtain maximum through the production. Earlier that agriculture which occurred on a smaller agriculture field through commercialization of agriculture, commercial grain farming, through which the larger agriculture fields are used for production through the modern techniques of farming. It's possible due to the technical factors. Third, institutional factors. Institutional means for improving the agriculture. Since independence towards modern in time, present in time, what kind of changes occur? For example, when India got the independence, zamindari system abolished by the government. Zamindari system finished by the government. That system in which as a landlord responsible for collection of revenue from farmers. They distribute the land among the poor farmers, tenants. We can say as tenants which were not owned their land. Clear? Landlords divided their land among the tenants. Tenants produce the crops and pay revenue to the zamindars. After the independence of our country, government finished their system of zamindari system. Clear? Second, as those earlier which were the tenants, which took as a land on a rent basis and produced the crops. They became as a landowners. Land उन्हें permanently दे दिया गया जो पहले उधार लेके rent पे या contract पे काम करते थे, ठीक है ना? इसके अलावा और बहुत सारे land reforms किए गए. People which came to India after the partition of country, a large number of lands were allotted to them. जो eastern और western Pakistan से India में आए थे उनको lands allot किए गए. तो ऐसे कुछ reforms, institutional reforms, modifications की गई, जिससे agriculture production बढ़ी. At the time of independence, our country was not self-sufficient in food grains. Our food grains imported from US towards India. But after the 1960s, 70s, when Green Revolution introduced India, it became as a self-reliant in food grains. Now our exports of our food grains move towards the European American countries. We are not importing goods. We earn a good salaries, good income through the export of food grains. Okay? It's due to the institutional reforms. Now, fourth, socio-cultural factors means certain number of societies are there, people are there, communities are there, which are still practicing the agriculture as per their traditional methods. For example, shifting cultivation, which was banned after the independence of our country, but still some of the communities which were basically preferred the shifting cultivation to the nomadic life. They displaced one place to another for the search of fertile lands. After independence of our country, the government of India, it banned on shifting cultivation. Still certain number of communities are there in the northeastern states, which are used as primitive methods of farming. They are not preferring to purchase the seeds from the markets. They prefer to use the such seeds which they conserved previous year. Jo grains last year unhone preserve kiye the for the consumption purposes, they use for a production. Such kind of a production is a low graded. Production is occur, but the low graded, less production occur through the such traditional seeds. Clear? So these are the socio-cultural factors. So these factors are responsible for the regional disparities. Ek particular state se dusre state, area to area, agriculture production. It has basically influenced by the these factors. So Dipanj, agriculture is a primary sector activity. Primary sector activity. This chapter, agriculture has broadly divided into four parts. First, types of agriculture. Types of agriculture. Types of agriculture. There are two types of agriculture. Two types of agriculture are there. Subsistence agriculture. Subsistence agriculture. And commercial agriculture. Commercial agriculture. Subsistence agriculture and commercial agriculture. Subsistence agriculture and commercial agriculture. Subsistence agriculture. Subsistence agriculture are of their two types. Primitive subsistence farming. Primitive subsistence farming. Not the two, three are there. Primitive subsistence farming. Primitive subsistence farming. Subsistence farming. Second as a shifting cultivation. Shifting cultivation. Shifting cultivation. Primitive subsistence farming. Primitive subsistence farming. Second as a shifting cultivation. Third, intensive subsistence farming. Intensive subsistence farming. Intensive subsistence farming. Intensive subsistence farming. Commercial farming again having their two parts. Plantation agriculture. Plantation agriculture. And mixed cropping. Mixed cropping. Mixed cropping. Two of the parts under the commercial farming, mixed cropping. Mixed cropping. Second are the agricultural patterns. Patterns of agriculture. Patterns of agriculture. Three agriculture seasons, Kharif, Rabi, Zayad. Rabi, Zayad. Kharif, Rabi, Zayad. Rabi, Zayad. Third, types of crops. Types of crops. Types of crops. There are four categories of crops which we will discuss in this chapter. Food crops. Food crops, fiber crops, kya kaha aapne? Very good. Fiber crops, beverage crops, and cash crops. Food crops includes wheat and rice. Food crops includes wheat and rice. Food crops includes wheat and rice, fiber crops, cotton, jute, cotton, jute, beverage crops, tea, coffee, tea, coffee, tea and coffee, tea, coffee, and cash crops. Medicines, rubber, sugar cane, oil seeds, जिसमें आपका सोयाबीन, सनफ्लावर, मस्टर्ड, स्पाइसेस भी होते हैं, हाँ जी, rubber, sugar cane, horticultural crops, fruit, vegetables, cash crops. And afterwards, the last as institutional and technical reforms. Institutional and technical reforms. Technical and institutional reforms. What kind of a modifications occurred in a present society in agriculture? Institutional and technical reforms, in which as a mostly as a preferential services provided to the farmers by the government of India. What services are they? We will discuss in this. Clear? This is as a brief description regarding of this chapter, a very small chapter. Clear? The matter related with the such crops, they may be as a hints will ask you in exams. For example, 210 days of a frost-free climatic conditions desired for the cotton production. They may be as a hint will mark, you have to identify the crop and write their conditions. What conditions are desired for their production? Like soil, temperature, rainfall, climatic condition, agriculture season, distributive areas, everything. Haan ji? First term mein aayega. In second term, there are two chapters. Haan ji? Haan, no problem. I think MCQs are a more difficult comparatively subjective portion. Clear? First type of agriculture, subsistence farming. Subsistence means when the farming occurred for the survival. For survival of family. When farmers, they generally produce as a crops for the completion of their needs of families. Needs of their families as the subsistence farming. And when the term primitive joined with it, primitive subsistence farming means traditional methods of farming opt on smaller agricultural fields to complete food requirements of families. It is now generally primitive subsistence farming. At presently, primitive subsistence farming generally practiced in northeastern states where through terraced, TERRACED, terrace means step, terraced structures are built across slopes of mountains for production. Especially the food crops are produced under it. Food crops produced under it. Second, as the shifting cultivation, also known as a slash and burn agriculture. It is also known as the slash and burn agriculture. Jhooming. It is known as a jhooming in India. In a northeastern state, it is known as a jhooming. In Indonesia, it is known as the ladang. In Mexico, it is known as a melpa. In Vietnam, as a re. So different names are given to the slash and burn agriculture. What is that? Earlier, the tribals, they cut the forest, and burnt the shrubs. Burnt shrubs and remaining ash they use for production of crops. Remaining ash used by tribals for production of food crops. Once when land start to lose their fertility, they shifted towards other areas for the search of fertile lands. This is known as a shifting cultivation. And how can they judge the land loses their fertility? How is this possible about that particular society where the machines are not utilized by the farmers? Production in every year. For example, first year as a production raised as a 10 quintals, second year as equivalent 10 quintals, but in third year as 9 quintals, fourth year as a 7 quintals. Regular decrease in a production shows that the land loses its fertility. Clear? Because in a shifting cultivation, farmers, they didn't use any kind of inputs. Agriculture inputs were not used by them, through which as a fertility of a land or a production, it can be increased. Not any of a method they opted to increase production. They use natural features, natural ways through which they raise production. So shifting cultivation, it is known with the different names in different places. Shifting cultivation, it is known as the jhooming, J-H-U-M-M-I-N-G. Jhooming in northeastern states of Assam. Dahia in Madhya Pradesh. Dahia, D-A-H-I-Y-A. Dahia in Madhya Pradesh. Podu in Andhra Pradesh. Podu in Andhra Pradesh. Bringa in Orissa. Bringa, B-R-I-N-G-A. Bringa in Orissa. Khil in Himalayan region, K-H-I-L. Khil in Himachal Pradesh. Kumari in Western Ghats. What is another term used in context of Western Ghats? Yes, Shivansh. Anybody from offline? Shivansh, raise your hand. Shivansh Agarwal. Yes, Shivansh, what's the answer? What we call to the Western Ghats, another term used in context of Western Ghats?
Sir, benevolent mountains.
No. Anybody? So it may be asked you in MCQ form. Sahyadris. Last year you read in our second chapter of geography. Sahyadris. S-A-H. Sahyadris, Western Ghats. In a Western Ghats, shifting cultivation known as a Kumari, K-U-M-A-R-I, and in other countries of the world, shifting cultivation in other countries of the world, it is known as a Milpa, M-I-L-P-A, M-I-L-P-A, in Mexico. Milpa in Mexico and Central America, Conuco in Venezuela, Conuco, Conuco in Venezuela, Ladang in Indonesia, Ladang, Ladang in Indonesia, Ray in Vietnam, Roca in Brazil, R-O-C-A, Roca in Brazil, but a shifting cultivation, it banned in India after independence. Why did the government it banned on a shifting cultivation? Because first, what were the reasons responsible for ban on shifting cultivation? In India, pollution. It caused pollution. Burning of trees, shrubs caused pollution. It increased pollutants in environment. Second, yes, dear, aapne kuch kaha tha? Wastage of land. Deforestation. This deforestation led to the soil erosion, the topmost layer of the earth crust removed by the running water and wind. Fourth, any other? Ill effects of shifting cultivation. Anybody else? Boliye. Very good, Nagpal. It disturbs ecological balance or biodiversity. Practice of a shifting cultivation disturbs biodiversity. Biodiversity, interrelationship between the flora and fauna. Very good, Hardik. Thank you. Biodiversity, clear? So due to the such reasons, government of India, it banned on shifting cultivation, which earlier banned by the Britishers in 1870s. At the age of 1870s, Britishers, they banned on shifting cultivation in Central India, because of which as a Munda rebellion, it was occur, which you read in your previous classes, Munda, Santhals, rebel, hill rebel, of a Central India. Central India, which was known for the Gond communities, which you read in your previous classes also. Clear? So the because of a forest law enacted by the Britishers at their age, they restricted the tribals' activities in forest land. Clear? Next type of agriculture is intensive subsistence farming. Till there, any doubts? Till there, any questions, any doubts? Yes, Dipansh. Kiska? deforestation, it caused pollution, it led soil erosion, it disturbs biodiversity. Practice of a shifting cultivation disturbs biodiversity or ecological balance. Kuch bhi keh sakte ho aap. What it means, the ecosystem? Jasleen? Ecosystem? Usme kya hote hain? Plants, animals, kya hote hain? Thoda niche karke bol do. Okay. Interrelationship between the flora and fauna with their physical environment. Very good. Vardik, aapko pata tha. Thank you. Aapne bataya. So this much for today. Any questions? Tomorrow we will continue from intensive subsistence farming. Haan ji. Reforms mein sudhar kya kiye gaye? Agriculture mein piche last 70 years mein kya modifications hui hain? Theek hai, usme kya hua ki pehle jo loans ka process tha, money lenders, landlords ki jo abhi banks, cooperatives aa gaye, woh har cheez isme aayegi. There is a farmer which has owned the 2 acres of a land. लैंड उसके पास कम है, उसको लोन नहीं दे रहा कोई भी, बैंक नहीं दे रहा है. अंडर सच सर्कमस्टेंसेस द केसीसी फैसिलिटी इज देयर, किसान क्रेडिट कार्ड्स आर देयर. उसको क्या करना है, अपने रीजनल जो भी बैंक है, नेशनलाइज्ड बैंक है, उसमें अपने डॉक्यूमेंट्स को डिपॉजिट करना है कि मेरे पास इतना एग्रीकल्चर फील्ड है. ठीक है, ऑन सच बेसिस बैंक हैज लेंडिंग द सम अमाउंट ऑफ मनी ऑन अ अकाउंट ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर फार्मर. दैट फार्मर इट कैन विदड्रॉ द मनी एट एनी ऑफ अ टाइम. जब वो मनी विदड्रॉ करेगा तब उस पर इंटरेस्ट लगेगा, वैसे नहीं लगेगा. चाहे पैसा 2 साल तक पड़ा रहे, इंटरेस्ट तब तक नहीं लगे जब तक वो दैट मनी इट हैज नॉट यूज्ड बाय द फार्मर. ये भी एक स्कीम है. एक और स्कीम है इन विच द गवर्नमेंट हैज इनिशिएटेड टू प्रोवाइड एज सब्सिडीज ऑन एग्रीकल्चर अप्लायंसेस. अगर कोई अपना ट्रैक्टर खरीदता है उसके ऊपर 10% की सब्सिडी मिलती है. ट्रैक्टर का अमाउंट 10 लाख का है, 10% मीन्स 1 लाख देना नहीं होगा. ठीक है, तो सब्सिडीज गिवन बाय द गवर्नमेंट टू प्रमोट एग्रीकल्चर. बहुत सारी और फैसिलिटीज हैं. अश्योर्ड इरिगेशन फैसिलिटी के लिए ट्यूबवेल्स, पंप सेट्स के अंदर सब्सिडी दी जाती है. फैसिलिटीज हैं अलग अलग, वो सारे के सारे रिफॉर्म्स आएंगे इसमें. हाँ, ड्यूरिंग द सोइंग पीरियड, जैसे भी पैडी का सीजन चल रहा है, राइस का जो सीजन, लगाने का सोइंग सीजन चल रहा है, एट दैट टाइम द मोर नंबर ऑफ द पावर सप्लाई प्रोवाइडेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट मिनिमम एज 8 आवर्स इन अ डे. 8 आवर्स. So any of the questions in your side? So this much for today.